tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Thus Countdown. Sean Luck, Alan Carr, Phil Lang, Harriet Kemsley, David O'Dougherty, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. What we've done is take regular Countdown and made it bigger, looser and ruder, a bit like your mum. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Sean is now one of the most critically acclaimed comedians of his generation, mainly because most of his generation died in World War I. And joining Sean tonight, it's Phil Wang. Phil is constantly trying to challenge stereotypes about Chinese people by being shit at maths and refusing to violently suppress the people of Tibet.
That's not true. I'm quite good at maths.
Up against them this evening, guest team captain Alan Carr. Yeah,
thank you.
Alan is a party animal, and that animal is a short-sighted beaver.
Good, I like
adorable.
That.
And Alan's teammate Harriet Kemsley. Harriet is one of the youngest contestants we've ever had on Cats Countdown. In fact, her final score tonight will count towards her GCSEs.
I wish they would.
Alan, you presented a Crufts show for Channel 4 a while back.
There's a whole week of Crufts with Claire Boldin. Didn't you watch it?
I've taped it. No spoilers. But was it fun?
It was a lot of fun, but it was terrifying because it's live TV and also you've got all those dogs there and some of them don't wear muzzles. And the last time I was bitten live on telly was when I was on Loose Women and I asked Janet Street-Port if I could try her comedy teeth on.
You've got a nerve doing that joke.
I can do to take the piss out the TV. She interviewed me once on radio, and when I played it back, you couldn't tell who was it. It was like two seagulls down the tip fighting over a sanitary towel. So it was good. It was all good.
Now, Harriet, you've described yourself as a competitive person. Is that going to affect the game this evening?
Yeah, I am. I think I take things too seriously. I'm quite competitive. I take things too seriously. Like, me and my husband, we play games, like, to really try and annoy each other. And the other day, he held me down on my bed and played my morning alarm ringtone in my ears for 7 minutes. But I think I'm winning in the long run because I've stopped taking the pill.
Nice. OK. Sean, what are you tired of people asking you?
You're going to be like this all day. The other thing people ask me all the time is, that laugh Jimmy Carr does, is it real? And I sort of go, I don't know. But it did appear in Series 5.
Are you going to be like this all day?
Yeah.
Phil, last time we were on here, you won. Mm. Are you expecting to win again against Alan and Harriet?
I'd not Harriet very well, so oh. Yeah.
I'll try really hard, though.
Okay.
Sorry. Sorry.
Why have I been saddled with her?
Sean, have you got a mascot this evening?
Yes, I do, Jimmy.
Oh, excellent.
Everyone loves the Panini sticker books, don't they?
Oh, yes.
And I thought, why is it just footballers that get one? Huh. Why not have one for everything in life? So I've come up with my sticker book of everything. Here we go. And a packet of stickers.
Oh, lovely.
So, yeah. Like, for example, the first page is authors. And there you've got Charles Dickens, Agatha Christie, Michael Owen. He's written a book. And then there's another page there. This is mysterious people. So there's like Anne Summers. That's Frey Bentos. Mr. Kipling, John West. Eddie Stobart. Let's have a bit of fun and see what I've got. So where have we got here? Oh, yes. Oh, Mr. Kipling. Could you feel that for me, please?
You've
got young fingers. Then we've got people who should retire. There's David Attenborough.
Oh,
it's tiny, just slung his hook. I'm sick of it. Christian Jessen. I think he's seen enough. I'd like it if we did this show. You know what? Originally, we started off as a different show, and we did this. I'd like it if we did 8 out of 10 cats did Embarrassing Bodies.
I'm 100% in.
It'd be great, wouldn't it?
Oh,
so easy. All you need is a box of matches and a glass of brandy. And whatever they show you, you just go, ugh.
Where will they be available?
Probably in a bin around here.
Phil, have you got a mascot?
Oh, yeah, Jimmy. Now, as you might be aware, I'm a bit of a ladies' man. Unfortunately, that bit is very small. Last time I was here, I tried to use the language of maths to woo the brilliant Rachel, yielding results that we in the engineering community would describe as fuck all. But this time around, I'm turning my attentions to the marvellous Susie with words. See if I can't charm her, win her affections, and maybe buff out that dent. Sorry. sorry, absolutely. Apologies. So. So I brought with me a collection of extremely obscure words. Words so obscure, not even Susie will have heard of them. And if this doesn't impress you, frankly, I'm out of ideas. First one, palerie. Palerie. Now, palerie is a piece of item of clothing that is placed on the head. It can be tall or wide. It's purely decorative. It's like a hat. Well, it's a hat. No, it's a hat. Yeah, so it's a hat. The next one's laptay. Laptay. Now, laptay is this liquid that's excreted by cows. And it's actually drinkable. It's quite nutritious. It's sort of milk-like. It's milk. Yeah, it's just milk. Sorry, yeah. This is just the Romanian dictionary. I should have guessed from the author, really. Sorry about that.
Harriet, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I brought along something to help everyone understand me a little bit. Last year, I got diagnosed with something called dyspraxia. If you've done it, it basically affects your coordination. Yeah, stay back. coordination and your logic and stuff. So I printed off my report that I got. They sent me this to try and make me feel better about myself, but it didn't. It says, it is very important that those around Harriet provide a supportive atmosphere. And it is suggested that Harriet be given little jobs or responsibilities to boost her confidence and make her feel that she is a person in the workplace or at home. It is crucial when she does these jobs, she is made to feel like she can be useful and is a valid member of society. They're suggesting people make up jobs for me to make me feel special.
Well, why don't you read out the rest of it and we'll see how you do?
Yeah, it says, we recommend that those around Harriet use encouraging statements like, good job, Harriet, or it's the taking part that counts. You might need that, yeah.
Great job.
Thank you. So much, Jimmy. Cheers. Thank you.
Alan, have you got a mascot?
It's a plea, really, to the producer. I don't know if you know, there's a new Elton John biopic coming out called Rocket Man, yeah. Now, I'm not going to lie, I am made for that part, innit? I look like Elton John, don't I? I have the same body shape as Elton John. And as Dame Judi Dench told me one day, it's not who you know, it's who you blow in Hollywood. And so this is my plea. I want to be the Elton John in the new, in the biopic. Here, look at this. Don't look like me. Wait there.
Am I on a team with him now? Really good.
Saturday, 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 Saturday.
So listen, and also, what I've done is we actually used a 3D state-of-the-art printer to make Elton's actual hands. A 3D state-of-the-art printer and two packs of Richmond sausages.
Oh, Nikita, you would never know.
Have you even got his temperance? Say something to me, Harriet.
Oh,
fuck off, you vile pig!
That was good.
Kevin, have you got your keyboard?
Yeah.
Could we just test the keyboard out?
Can in the wind.
Yeah, can in the wind.
There you go. Yeah, just hear this.
Oh.
It's no sacrifice.
I feel like we're in an old people's home. And they said, you got some entertainment to offer.
But I've got a Kiki D.
What, you've got Kiki D?
Yeah.
Don't go breaking my heart,
yeah.
Kiki D.
She's my cleaner, Veronica. Bring her in. We have got such chemistry. Woo-hoo! Wake up. Wake up, Kiki.
Elton John and Kiki D, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. It's me, Alan.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, we've got David O'Doherty. Well, David, if you're here, who's figuring out what's been haunting the local fairground with your pal Scooby? David, we haven't seen you in a while. How have you been?
I'm good. These are challenging times to be living in, Susie. I think the only people who are enjoying the world at the moment are racists and the makers of Fever Tree Tonic. There's times I think maybe we should just blow up the world. You know, in Star Wars, when Princess Leia sees her home planet destroyed, she's a bit sad, but part of her's also like, yeah, it's a lot of arseholes there, you know?
And with David, of course, it's Susie Dent. Here's a fun fact. Susie's 14th book came out recently, and the Ministry of Defence are keeping Britain's nuclear codes on page 2, where no one will ever find them. Susie, have you any favourite words that people get wrong?
Because I eavesdrop all the time, so I'm always picking up. So it's not so much words, but just expressions. So one I tweeted about quite recently, I was standing behind a woman in a coffee queue, and her friend got her a cappuccino, and she's like, I'm internally grateful. And then in a supermarket, this is a couple of years ago, there were a group of lads just buying beer, as much alcohol as they could get in their trolley. And they said, come on, lads, we're going to drink ourselves into Bolivia.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel's the hottest mathematician in the country. But to be fair, that's a bit like being the smartest person on Love Island. How do you switch off your brain at the end of a busy day?
Is
there a switch?
Yeah. We get into bed.
Slower.
Go online. Look for something fun. When you've found something, you know, hard enough, just have a go at that for as long as I feel like. And then when I'm finished, just roll over and go to sleep. Love the puzzles online, Jimmy.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Kite. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Alan and Harry, you get the first pick of the letters.
What do we want? Vowel?
Yeah. Yep. Good Go start. For it, love.
Then what do you think?
Alan, you've got one bit of hair. Well, yeah. Well, you've got one bit of hair that's kind of... That's, I mean, it looks great. I don't know whether that's the... Whether it's all meant to be doing that.
What? No, you're freaking me out now. What's wrong?
It's going quite up.
Well, there's one bit going up.
Oh, my God. Thank God. Thank God. Consonant, please.
Z.
Now we need to... We've got another problem. Well, you look like the action man I had with a beard. It's all... Did you go into a barber's and gone everything on my head the same length?
I got this haircut about a month ago. He had no English, and there was two pictures in the barbershop, a picture of Elvis and a picture of a motorbike. And I think I got the motorbike.
Here, you can have this back. I don't need this. I've got this. Saturday! 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 What for Greg are we?
We've got an O and a Z. It's a good start. I'm doing very well.
Oz, write that down. let's have three vowels. Come on, let's get going. Three vowels.
E. I. E.
Alan, let Harriet pick the letters. The jobs.
Yes. Pretend I didn't hear.
Hey, yes. Why don't you pick some consonants? You're good at that.
Please, can we have one consonant?
No, it's great.
Another consonant. All consonants.
N.
Is that too many?
S? No, I think that's very good.
Yeah, yeah, good girl.
Okay, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. We made mini versions of everyone. Sean, the years have not been kind. I mean, you were a very handsome young man.
Which one are you talking about? Have you started drinking yet?
I love her.
I mean, he's look at the swag as well. The only slight criticism I've got is he's got real teeth.
Who's older, your actual teeth or the little boy?
How old are you? Seven. Same age. It's the Cats Does Countdown clones, everyone. Give them a round of applause. Thank you very much. Hey there. Thanks very much, everyone.
Like when you see the first Harry Potter and the last one.
Okay. Alan, how many you got?
Seven.
You've got seven?
Yeah, I've got seven.
Oh, well, we'll wait and see. Harriet, how many have you got?
I've got five.
Sean, how many have you got?
Six.
Six. And Phil?
Seven.
Well, let's, Harriet, let's hear your five.
I've got onesie. Susie, is that a word? It's like a, yeah, you know
it's
what it is.
It's a six-letter word is what it is.
Can I just say, she's written scones, but with a Z at the end.
OK, what about onesie? Onesie?
Onesie. O-N-E-S-I-E, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Excellent word.
Sean, what's your six?
Nieces.
Ooh, that's
nieces.
As in, I've been having a bit of trouble with my nieces. Can you get these bloody nieces off my lawn? I want to take a contract out on these nieces. Do you kill nieces?
Phil, you're seven.
My seven is notices. Oh. As in, notices have been taken out against Sean for how he treats his nieces.
Alan, for 7 points.
I've got notices too.
7 points to both teams. David, Susie, could they have done any better?
There is an eight there, which is the name of my first car, Seicento, meaning 600 in Italian, but
yeah,
it creeps in.
It describes the style of Italian art and literature in the 17th century.
And also the Fiat Seicento. It's only three door, but the legroom's excellento.
Okay, on to our first numbers round. Okay, Sean, Phil, your turn to pick the numbers.
Four. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Phil.
How's it going, man?
You're really good at talking to ladies, aren't you, Phil? That was pretty smooth. The one mistake I would say I'd call you up on is when you called her a man.
Sorry, dude. May I have two of your largest numbers and three not large?
You can. And you know how we've got six gaps there?
Yeah, I'm still trying to think about the last one.
Okay.
I'm feeling small.
Are you?
Yeah, that's right.
What we have now are 7, 4, 2, 9, and then the big ones, 125. And the target, 488.
Okay, and your time starts now. Okay, so the target was 488. Sean, did you get it?
Yes.
Phil, did you get it?
487.
Which is a simple no will suffice. Harriet, did you get it?
Can I get like a 10% margin, maybe?
Sorry, are you saying that because you brought in your dyspraxia report, you want extra time and a margin of error?
That's what I'm saying, yep. I got 472. So it's not it. No.
No.
Okay.
No. Okay. You did not get it.
If you want to discriminate, that's it.
Well, now I feel terrible. I'm joking. I don't have feelings. Alan, what did you get?
I got 487.
487, OK, so close. So, Sean, how did you do it?
4 times 100. 7
times 9. 7 times 9,
63. Add 25.
Wow. Well done.
I mean, 10 points to Sean. OK, the scores at the moment, Alan and Harriet have 7 points, Sean and Phil have 17. And here is your teaser. The words are wang tits and the clue is just bat them away. That's wang tits, just bat them away. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were wang tits. The clue was just bat them away. It was, of course, swatting. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Harriet. So, Sean, your turn to choose the letters.
Vowel, please.
Oh. I.
And a consonant.
D.
And a vowel, please.
O.
Consonant.
C.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
R.
And a consonant.
R. Got three. T.
Cot.
Four.
And a consonant.
B.
Watch out.
And I think I'm going to have to go for another vowel.
I.
And your time starts now. How many?
Well, I don't know.
How could you not know?
Because I don't know if they're words.
None of those are words, love.
Go on, what's the word?
Cardi.
As in Cardi B, definitely a word.
That is a word, it's
no,
a name.
No, she's a singer.
Okay. Carb. Is carb a word?
Just checking, is that in the singular? It is, yeah. Very good.
So, four. You got four.
I've got four.
Sean, four to beat.
Well, I think I'll plump for a safe five, then. Idiot.
Quite close to Sean. Could they have done any better? David, Susie.
Triadic, which is a group of three, don't say anything.
It's a magic number, isn't it, Susie?
Catbird.
What's a catbird?
It's a song where it makes kind of mewing calls.
Well, that was a lazy day in the bird naming community.
It's a sexist way of referring to Catwoman.
She's always got a pint of lager. Catbird.
OK, so at the end of that, Alan and Harry have 7, Sean and Phil have 22.
You're back in now, so you can get it back.
Right, now it's time for Alan and Phil to go head-to-head. Alan, your turn to pick the numbers.
2 big ones and 4 little ones, please.
We've got 1, ooh, 8, 4, 2, and the big ones, 25 and 50, and the target, 241.
OK, so 241 is the target. Your time starts... Oh, I can't reach the button.
Do you want me to...?
Yeah, if you press the button, that'd be great,
I've
and then
we'll
start. I've
never pressed the button before. Time starts now.
Cool, could you grab my head?
This one?
Yeah, no, my one, yeah. Yeah, OK. Is better, thank you. 241 was the target. Phil, did you get it?
I got 2, 4, and then 6, I think.
Alan,
245.
I got 242.
God damn.
Okay, 242. Alan, how did you do it?
Okay. 2 + 4 + 1 = 7.
Yeah.
Times the 50.
2 + 4 + 1 = 7 = 350.
350.
Rachel? Could you look again, please?
Is dyspraxia catchy? Oh, yeah, that's been a terrible mistake.
No, okay, no. Phil, how did you get 245?
Oh, 8 times 50.
What's that supposed to be? 400?
Yeah. I think it is catching. I think it's coming down. Sorry. 50 times 4, sorry.
This is some bullshit going on here.
50 times 4 is 200.
It is, yeah.
And then that's already closer than 350, so I'll stop there.
I think I got it!
Well, a couple of things. Firstly, you're not meant to be playing, and secondly, you definitely didn't get it, but let's hear...
OK. 4 times 50.
That's right.
Yes.
200.
I think you have got it.
Plus... 4 plus... 2 times 25, so that makes 50.
Yeah.
And then you 50. Minus 1 plus 8.
Yes!
And the award for the most patronising round of applause in British television goes to us. That's for all of us. Harry, we're going to give you the points. Well done, you. 10 points. OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. David O'Doherty, what have you got for us?
Well, I've got... What is this? It's the party machine! You guys... Age ain't nothing but a number, Susie. But it's also a very accurate barometer of how old you are. And... this is the oldest I've ever been, and I do think... if I could just go back and talk to the 18-year-old me, you know, what would I say? Hello, 18-year-old me. This is you in the year 2018. And I'm here to tell you so much stuff about life, happiness, and love. David, pay attention. David, take out your headphones. What the hell is that noise? In this song, I'll be playing two characters. This is you in the year 2018. Bullshit! If this is me in the future, tell me something about myself that only I would know. Before the mathematics state exam you took when you were 14 years old, you wrote the quadratic equation on your dick. Yeah, that is true, but I bet a lot of people... Hey, what's it like in the future? What do I do in the future? Am I a footballer? Am I like a rock and roll star? Oh, shit. You do have musical comedy. Oh, the worst genre of comedy. You know, what instrument did I choose from the pantheon of musical instruments? Do I play the guitar like Bill Bailey or a grand piano? Oh, shit. Do you know the crappy plastic keyboard in the attic you got for your confirmation? No! Hang on, 2018, you're 42. Are you telling me in the future I play a crappy plastic keyboard? Oh, God, no! Where do I do these songs in the future? On Countdown. You know, what Countdown? The TV show with the brainiest people in the world on it. No, actually, that's changed quite a lot in the future, too.
David Dobbity, everyone. That was a lovely song, and also, I'm not entirely sure you're not having a breakdown.
It is relative. Age is so... You know what I mean. I remember when I was 20, one of my friends once made out with a 25-year-old, and we were like, oh, that is so disgusting. Did she taste of death?
OK, so Alan and Harriet have 17, Sean and Phil have 22. And here's your teaser. The words are naked pick, and the clue is something to worry about. That's naked pick, something to worry about. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were naked pick. The clue was something to worry about. It was, of course, panicked. Right, before we go on with the show, he doesn't work here anymore, but he keeps on turning up. It's Joe Wilkinson.
All right, Jimmy.
What are you wearing, mate?
Well, you mean my new trainers? Yeah, nice, isn't it? But, got from George Asda.
No, I mean the rest of it.
Oh, right, yeah. Well, you know I'm banging to me fashion. And so I've brought out my own fashion range. I make all my outfits out of things I find in and around my house. You probably can't tell, but this waistcoat is actually made out of my front and back door. The only downside is my house is being broken into a hell of a lot more. But, I've got other outfits, though. Do you want to see them? Pablo, let's show him this one. Come on, mate. It's a pair of shoes I designed. The only downside is now we have to shit in the garden. And probably should have flushed them first. Sorry about that, Pablo. Right, I'll show them the next one, mate. Jen, this is an outfit I made from bits and bobs now I had in the house.
You've got dog shit bin in the house.
And all that reminds me, I've added a little accessory to this. I've added sleeve tassels. What next? Oh, yes.
Let me guess, you made an outfit out of your fridge.
Don't be a fuckwit, Jimmy. This is just my fridge. That's how I found my half-brother Fabio when I woke up this morning. We think he climbed in the fridge during the night and kicked his feet out the top. He does things like that because he's a fucking idiot. I really fancied a Müller fruit corner. Let's play Countdown!
And just out of interest, the letterbox there...
You can push your penis through it, yeah.
OK, on with the game.
Joe, there's someone at the door.
OK, on with the game. Alan, Harriet, yes. Your turn to choose the letters.
Vowel?
Yeah. Yep.
A?
Four consonants.
Right. Please. L.
Yeah, come on, we're really behind, aren't we? Yeah.
M. Q.
Vowel.
Yep.
E. I don't know. I'm bad at making decisions.
Do
another
you?
Vowel. Yeah. Yeah, you. Thank you. What, more vowels.
No.
Three.
Oh, no, one more consonant,
one, yeah,
please.
One more consonant. Thank you.
Oh, yes, OK, and your time starts now. OK. Alan, how many?
Five.
Harriet, how many?
Five.
Phil, how many?
Five.
Sean?
Five.
OK. What, Harriet, what's your five-letter word?
I got learn.
Alan?
Five, grain.
Grain.
Yeah, grain.
Sean?
Was there an I, rather?
Oh, shit, do you know what?
I thought you said.
Oh, he just wrote an I.
I put that down as an I and it's an L. I'm sorry. I'm not. I don't want to hang around you anymore.
I'm actually doing very well, so.
Sean?
Gruel.
Gruel.
As in, nieces, it's time for your gruel.
Phil?
Oh, glare.
Glare?
Glare. Mm-hmm.
Well, 5 points to both teams.
Jojo laughing is the highlight.
Why don't you put them inside the door, Joe, inside the window?
Oh, don't.
That looks a bit. Don't do that. That looks a bit wrong. Like a really horny Jehovah's Witness turn.
David, why have you got your hands in a cup?
No.
What are you doing?
I feel this isn't going to go well for me. We will be having words.
OK. David, Susan, could they have done any better?
There's two. Granule, which is the powder you make a grandmother from. And angular, Susie found.
Oh, yeah.
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. David O'Doherty, what have you got for us?
Well, there are several topics that no songwriter has yet tackled. Susie, and one of those is your partner finding where you have written down the list of everyone you've ever boned in your life. And that's about to change right now. She found the list written in pencil on the back inside cover of the telephone directory. 11 sets of initials. And she knew what it was. She said, is this the list of everyone that you've ever done it with? Did you write it once while you were bored and on hold? No, he said. And technically he wasn't lying, because he hadn't actually been on hold. He was waiting for the phone people to ring him back. What is it then, she said? I'll tell you what it is now, he said. His mind going quicker than it had ever gone before. That is my under-10s football team. He genuinely thought he was getting away with it. Till she said, tell me about this player here. Pointing at her own name. Was he any good? Tell me all about him. Yes, he said, he was the best player that I ever played with. But he quit the team when he found out that maybe we were a slightly larger team than he had originally anticipated before joining the team. Well, that's not why he quit the team, she said. He quit the team when he found out that according to the list, he wasn't the last person to have joined the team.
So the scores at the moment, Alan and Harriet have 22, Sean and Phil have 27. And here is your final teaser. The words are knob dose, and the clue is take one at both ends. That's knob dose, take one at both ends. See you after the break. The answer to the teaser, the words were knob dose. The clue was take one at both ends. It was, of course, bookends. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Phil, your turn to choose the letters.
I mean, do you want to take this, Joe?
Yeah, go on then.
And a consonant, please, Joe.
Oh, sorry, Rachel. The lads have made you some bits and bobs.
Oh, wow.
Pablo's made you a knuckle duster out of a...
Oh, amazing.
Out of an old toilet duck bottle.
Maybe I'll wear it on this hand.
I bet it smells great, that necklace.
Yeah, it's an ashtray, mate. There you go. It's nice.
Lovely.
Rachel, I know you love the D, but we need more letters.
OK. Can I have another consonant, please?
T.
And then a consonant.
L. L.
Consonant.
G.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
S.
Toilets.
Consonant.
Just find a T.
G.
Oh.
Best I can do.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now.
Singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling! I'm happy again.
This reeks of piss.
You're welcome.
Sean, what did you get?
Six.
Phil?
Seven.
Alan?
Six.
Harriet?
If we're going with words that I know what they mean, then it's three.
Well, let's
four,
hear...
Four, because you just add an S on. Four.
Amazing. OK, what is your four?
Dogs.
OK, Alan.
Like I said, I've got six. Oldest.
Oldest?
That's good, isn't it?
Sean?
Silted.
Oh.
Silted.
Ooh. Bit of geography there.
Oh, lovely.
An alluvial plain. Everyone remember that?
No.
It's when a river meanders, yeah, and the meander becomes so extreme, it breaks off and forms an isolated...
A bit like this
pond.
Anecdote.
Yes.
I think they just don't pay enough attention at school. Like, I just did a lot of home economics. Do you know home economics? It's like economics, but for girls. You learn how to bake a cake and cover a black eye.
OK. Phil, what's your seven?
Toggles.
Toggles. Yeah, like OK, 7 points to Phil. David, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, yes. There's a doggiest, which is...
What, sorry? Susie?
I did get that one quite quickly. Doggiest, yeah. The most doggy.
But can you have the word, like, cattiest?
No, but it's not about somebody's eyes can be doggy, can't they? So you have the doggiest brown eyes I've ever seen.
What a horrible thing to say.
You might as well say shit brown eyes. So your lies are like two turds.
OK, Alan and Harriet have 22 points. Sean and Phil have 34. OK, fingers on buzzers, everyone. Time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Oh, God, that's a bit of a mate. Do I press something?
Yeah, there's a buzzer. Press the buzzer.
No,
the
no,
buzzer.
That's...
I mean, no one's ever failed to press the buzzer before. Do I press something? Yeah, fingers on buzzers was the clue to that. What do I press? And then you were just banging stuff. Oh, is that it? Is that the buzzer?
You better have it.
It seems too easy, so I don't think
what
I
is
do.
It? What
is it? Is it really shit? The taking part that counts.
Okay, fingers on buzzers. Restart the clock now. Okay, let's have a look.
Wow.
Hairstyle.
Oh. Hairstyle? Oh.
Hairstyle.
So the final scores are Alan and Harriet have 22, but tonight's winners with 34, Sean and Phil. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Cakes. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching home. That's it from us. Good night.
The connoisseur of chicken, Elijah, and his crew review everything from fast cars to kebabs. Peng Life, it's the new series tonight at 11:05. Before that, in betweener Joe Thomas and comedy fella John Bishop. They're both live on the Friday leg.